I'm going to share the fluffiest, most delicious za'atar bread today. Super easy. We start with a cup of warm water, 1 tablespoon of yeast, and 1 tablespoon of sugar. Mix it all up together and let it activate for about 5 to 7 minutes until bubbles form just like this. And once your yeast is ready, you'll know when it's ready. It's going to be very bubbly and foamy. You're going to add it to 3.5 cups of all-purpose flour and add a bunch of salt into it, about 1 tablespoon, and some olive oil, about 2 tablespoons. So olive oil, you need 3/4 cup for the whole recipe, not for the dough. So you're going to use about 2 tablespoons of olive oil in your dough, and then another 1/2 cup of water to bring the whole dough together. So you might need less or more water depending on your flour type, and then you're just gonna knead it until you get a nice supple and soft dough that doesn't stick to your hands anymore. Just keep working it. You can never overwork this dough, or you don't have to knead it too much. So this dough is very forgiving. You can just keep kneading it or not knead it enough, it doesn't matter. But you need something that looks like this, and you're going to put a little more olive oil on it so it doesn't stick, it rises, and then cover it up and let it rest for 2 hours. For the za'atar topping, I have 1 tablespoon of freshly squeezed lemon juice, and the rest of the olive oil should be about 1/2 cup, and a little bit of salt, just a dash to bring out all the flavors, and 2 tablespoons of good quality za'atar. I think I just bought this on Amazon one day, and I have it in the fridge. You're gonna mix it all together and let it sit and marry and grow and blossom while the bread rises. After 2 hours exactly, your dough is nice and fluffy. You're gonna bring it down a little bit by tapping it, by moving it around, but don't press it too hard. You're just gonna work it gently because you want the bubbles inside, and you're gonna roll it and roll it and roll it, and again, let it rest for another hour. I wanted a fluffier bread this time, so I picked a small baking tray, but you can pick a bigger one, as big as you want, and make it as flat or as thick as you want. It depends on your preference. So my tray is about 6 by 12 inches. I'm gonna press this into my tray, and at first the dough is gonna resist opening up, and then it's gonna relax and let you move it around. You're gonna start making dimples into your dough, and then let it rest for another 15-20 minutes, so the dough comes back to itself and it's comfortable with itself, and then you'll put the za'atar seasoning on top. Right now you're preheating your oven at 350, because you're gonna bake this at 350 for about 30 minutes or until everything is done and the bottom of the bread is nice and crunchy. I had a small tray, so I had to put this in a larger baking tray so the oil wouldn't spill as it bakes. So please do that if your tray is small like mine. And after baking it, this is what it looks like. It is absolutely gorgeous, incredibly delicious, with a piece of feta cheese. It was just heaven, especially warm out of the oven. I really enjoyed making this and eating it. It is my go-to. I hope you make this and you enjoy. Thanks for watching.